Hey everybody, thanks for visiting Woo Art. In this video, we'll make a shrug by using what we've learned from the last two videos. On top of that, I'll show you some powerful expressions. With this method, you can adjust your shrug very quickly. See, that's mind-blowing, right? I can hear that you are so thrilled. Then, why don't you start right now? Okay, create an ellipse layer. Basically, we are going to use two shape layers, one for the head and another one for the tail. Animate the circle like this. Let's adjust the speed graph. A point in a higher place means it moves fast, and in a lower place means the opposite. So the head will move fast at the beginning, slow down until the middle of the timeline, and speed up at the end. I want to stretch the circle when it moves fast, like this. But the angle doesn't match with its direction at the moment. There is an easy way to orient this along the path. Right-click on the layer, and click the Auto Orient menu under the Transform. Choose Orient Along Path, then you'll see that the layer rotates automatically along the direction. Okay, let's add the stretching animation. The first thing you need to do is getting the speed value from its position. Let's declare the speed value as. Pick with the position and add dot speed at the end. Then you can use the speed value by calling s. We'll use different numbers for each dimension, so split the scale value. We need to scale the value down because, as you can see in this example, the speed value is too big to use directly for the scale. So multiply it by a really small number. And multiply x scale by 1 plus s. Multiply y scale by 1 minus s. Since it's about stretching, not just scaling, as one axis increases, the other should decrease. Yes, it's working well. Okay, let's animate the scale to make it look three-dimensional. Yeah, nice. Moving on to the tail part. Duplicate the layer. And erase every keyframe from this. Okay, there are four ways of retrieving a layer in After Effects. Layer itself, by number, by name, and by target layer. We're gonna use the second way this time. Index means a number of a layer and it defines by its order in the timeline. For example, the index of tail on the bar 01 is 1 and the head is 2. So if I put the script like this, it always indicates a layer below this. So you don't need to edit a script each time you duplicate a layer. Okay, we're gonna take the position value. Another very useful method is valueAtTime. By this method, you can retrieve the value by the time. If you put time minus 0.2 into the method, you can get the value roughly 6 frames earlier. Let's try it out. Do you know what I mean? Do the same thing for the scale. You need to retrieve the scale, not the position for this. Okay, cool. Let's make it shrink with each duplication. It's simple, just multiply by a number smaller than 1. Yeah, when you duplicate the tail layer, you'll see the magic. It's super cool, right? Adjust the movement a little. Okay, let's add a wiggle into the head layer to make it move a bit irregularly. Alright, the base work is done. Let's make a control layer. Firstly, for the head, we need two controllers. One for the amplitude argument of wiggle, another one for the intensity of stretching. Add two slider controls. Make two more for the tail. One for the time gap between each layer, another one for the resizing. Okay, replace the amplitude value with the amp slider. Next is the stretching slider. Ooh, I love it. Move on to the tail. Put the gap slider. And the resize slider as well. Don't forget to replace the gap value. Okay, nice. You can adjust the motion very quickly and easily by this process. But that's not the only benefit. You can create even more complex and fascinating motion by animating these sliders. Let me show you a quick example. The concept is, of course, totally up to you. So I believe that you can make the better one. Okay, this is the simple example. I made it look a bit more irregular. I didn't use any effects here, but if you put some extra effort, you can make something like liquid-looking effect, or make something geometrical motion graphic. It's really fancy, right? Like I said in the first video, expression opens the door to whole new possibilities. So please, don't give up trying. I support you with more interesting videos. If you want to see them, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel. This video ends here. See you next time. Bye!